Hello students, welcome to the next continued part of research areas in psychology. Let me explain you about the biological psychology or physiological psychology. Physiological psychology or biological psychology mainly studies about biological basis of behavior, how brain and the glands, endocrine glands, influence the behavior of an individual. They also study the influence of neurotransmitters or neurochemicals, and also how a neurological structure influences the behavior or any abnormality in the neurology, that is in the central nervous system, how it influences the behavior of an individual. That is the major area of research in biological or physiological psychology. Next, going to study about the next branch of psychology, that is called cognitive psychology. Cognitive psychology mainly studies about the cognitive processes or information processing aspects. Mainly how our brain processes the information. It includes the sensation, attention, perception, memory, language, thinking, emotion, reasoning, and many more. Higher order processing and lower cognitive processing. These are the two types of processing involved in cognitive processing. Cognitive psychology has also extended branches of researches, namely cognitive neuroscience and artificial intelligence. These are some of the extended areas of research in cognitive psychology. Next, we are going to know about cross-cultural psychology. As the name indicates, it studies about wide variety of cultural issues, how the cultures across the world creates difference in the psychology or psychological functioning of the individual. So that is studied in cross-cultural psychology. Next, we are going to know about psychometrics. A lot of importance that a branch has nowadays is nothing but psychometrics. Psychometrics mainly deals with the psychological measurement of an individual. It may be the study of personality of an individual, memory of an individual, intellectual abilities of an individual, or maybe perceptual abilities or emotional status, emotional intelligence, or maybe language skills or leadership skills or soft skills, and many more. Psychometrics uses standardized psychological test developments, and based on the psychological tests, they assess or determine the psychological aspects in an individual. Psychometrics is strongly associated with research statistics and research methodology also. Next, we are going to know about evolutionary psychology. What is evolutionary psychology? Evolutionary psychology is somewhat related to physiological psychology. It mainly studies about how the human behavior is influenced by biology. But it studies furthermore how an individual thinks or how a person reacts to the natural environment through the natural selection process. And they also study about comparative aspects. In the sense, they compare between the genders also. That is, males and females. How males think differently from females. Why there is difference. So, all these are part of evolutionary psychology. Next, going to the applied areas of psychology. Applied areas in psychology. There are different types of applied areas in psychology. First one is called clinical psychology. Very popular and well established field in India. This clinical psychology mainly involves the therapeutic rehabilitation and counseling aspects for mentally ill, mentally retarded and abnormal and antisocial people. Here, clinical psychology requires some of the practice or expertise in the field of psychology. The person who has to become clinical psychologist has to pursue his master's in clinical psychology and he has to become the clinical psychologist. Then they are working with mentally ill or mentally retarded or drug addicts and they try to tackle their problems or psychological problems of wide variety through psychological therapies, counseling, testing and research methods, and also neurological methods also they apply. That is called neuropsychological test inventories they use, and they study the abnormality or any problem behaviors and also try to solve them using clinical procedures. As I said you, that is nothing but counseling, psychotherapy, psychometrics and research, and also they are involved in rehabilitation. So most of the individuals who practice psychology in India, they practice mainly the clinical fields. They practice in clinical fields. Next, going to the next important applied areas of psychology, that is called counseling psychology. What do you mean by counseling? Nowadays it is very popular term, counseling. So counseling is nothing but it is a procedure of giving assistance to any person or guidance to any person having lot of personal or psychological problems. Counseling can be given for a single problem or for many problems. That depends upon the person. So counseling requires expertise. So counseling requires expertise in that field. A counseling psychologist, after taking clinical case interview or case interview or diagnostic methods, he can counsel the counselee or his client so that he can resolve the issues. Individuals of any age group can obtain the counseling so that the individuals with maladjustment or any personality related problems or psychological problems, academic problems, any problems, they can get guidance and assistance so that they can resolve their problems. Next, going to the next continuation in the next video. Thank you.